what's up? Got some new coaches. Got an offensive line coach promoted to defensive coordinator. It's kind of weird, man. I don't know. Kind of different. One more time, I'm gonna stop. 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 One more time, I swear I'm gonna stop. Look out behind you. It's gonna be on all you. Bring some case of freedom. But so better be in front of me. You only burden me. Looking at your last small friend. It doesn't matter what prize you win. I'll sweat and pass the sight. Staring through the killer in your eyes. Persist by. Now, there's a lot of talk amongst the fans, the media, you know, and everybody else as to, wow, man, this is weird, man. This doesn't make no sense. It's not going to work out. This, that, and the other. Yada, yada, yada. You know, this is just Andy Reid, you know, promoting someone who's just been loyal, you know, to the organization for years. And, you know, just like Sean McDermott, you know, and then look how he turned out. So, I mean, that's a lot. I think a lot of people are seeing the Sean McDermott promotion and reflecting this signing onto that, or this promotion onto Sean McDermott's, because it's similar in a way, sort of. But the thing that strikes me weird, as odd of this signing is, okay, forget the whole thing of, well, does he have experience, and does he have this, does he have that, is he capable? Forget all of that. My thing is if you're going to promote somebody in anything, you have to have prior success in an NFL. It should be very recent prior success to your promotion. Now, in 2010, as the offensive line coach for, you know, the Eagles, Juan Castillo, his offensive line was very subpar at best. I mean, the offensive line needs a lot of work, and you know, to me, I find it odd that after the season ended for us against the Packers, there were some coaches fired on the defensive side of the ball. And most notably, Sean McDermott, the former defensive coordinator, getting fired. And it's just odd to me that Juan Castillo would be promoted after a very subpar, at best, offensive line last year to defensive coordinator. I don't understand it. I mean, and especially towards the end of the year, the offensive line just slowly degressed. They didn't get better. They just slowly started wearing down, man. And it showed, because Vic was getting pounded, man. He got hurt. He was banged up and he was sore. I mean, and it even showed through his play too, because he went from, you know, his new style for him, you know, standing in the pocket, reading the defenses, he kind of got away from that a little bit and gotten more to running more, you know, his first natural instinct is what he's always done. And he started to slowly, little by little, get back to that because the offensive line could not protect. And I don't understand how Juan Castillo, you know, his work being reflected through these players, how he could get promoted to defensive coordinator. I don't get that. I don't get that at all. Now, with that being said, am I disappointed? Am I upset? Am I not happy about him being promoted as him being the defensive coordinator? No, I'm not. I'm open to see what he can do. I'm really hoping that, you know, he will, you know, turn his defense around. And not, I mean, they need work on defense, but just help him improve. You know, they said he's a defensive-minded coach. Okay, well, I mean, he was, I believe, a secondary coach. He coached at Texas A&I. I believe he was a secondary coach or, you know, something, but he also played linebacker. You know, so, you know, obviously he does have at least a little common sense for the defensive side of the ball. And it helps, too, that he knows offensive line schemes and whatever, whatnot, so that helps him as well. So I'm open to see what he can do as a defensive coordinator. I'm leaving my opinion on him as a defensive coordinator open for judgment at a further date. I'm not going to judge him yet as a coordinator. But the promotion itself, I don't understand it. It makes no sense to me. Howard Mudd. Now, this guy, I mean, he has a great track record. I mean, for like, what, 10 years, 11 years or so, he was the Indianapolis Colts offensive line coach. And in my opinion, for years, man, Indianapolis with Peyton Manning back there has had one of the best, if not the best, offensive lines in the NFL. Peyton Manning hardly ever got sacked. You know, even now. So, you know, this guy knows what he's doing with the offensive line. And, you know, I'm happy with that. You know, and I believe in Andy Reid's philosophy as far as it all starts with the offensive and defensive lines. Success there creates success for everybody behind him. I honestly believe that, and that comes from me used to being a defensive line player. I played some defensive end. I played some defensive tackle when I was younger. So I believe that. I believe in that philosophy. And this guy, if he can do what he did with Indianapolis, if he can do that with us in Philly, this offense is just going to be, I mean, it's already dynamic. It's already, like, ridiculously good. And it's just going to take it to another level if he can do what he did in Indianapolis. So I'm happy about that, man. I'm good with that signing. Now, Jim Washburn, the new defensive line coach, you know, I'm excited about that, too, because he's had success with the Titans most recently. And what I don't know if anybody's heard this, anybody else has heard this, but I've heard rumors here and there, small rumors, that there might be a way where the Eagles might end up with Albert Haynesworth. Jim Washburn was Albert Haynesworth's defensive line coach in Tennessee. And he was very successful under that 4-3 system. Now, obviously we all know he's not that great. He's had, you know, towards the end of the year last year, he was playing good. But the 3-4 is not a system for him, obviously. He's even stated that and bitched and moaned about it. Fine. I would be open to having Albert Haynesworth come in. As long as the contract that he has, which is ridiculous, absurd for like a defensive tackle, as long as that was restructured, I'm good. I'm open for, you know, a formed opinion to be made later about Juan Castillo as the defensive coordinator, but, you know, I hope he does good, man. I hope he brings his defense to another level and improves it. I'm hoping he does. So I'm happy with that. I'm happy with the offensive line and defensive line coaches being signed, Washburn and Mudd. I'm happy with that. I think they will improve what we have. So with that being said, I'm open for a future opinion on Castillo's defensive coordinator skills. I'm open for opinion for that to be made later. So like I said, his promotion was weird to me, though. I don't understand it. But it is what it is, man. We have to deal with it. We can't change it as fans or media. Might as well ride with it. That's what I'm thinking, man. I mean, there's no reason unless he gives us reason to not like it. And that's not going to happen right now in off season. So anyway, man, that's all I got. Peace. Always, man. Go Birds, no matter what.